Basically, they rejected it, saying that 2 out of 4 years, they're not accepting.
Correct.
And did they say why?
Well, basically, they said that since I was applying for a general B, the first two companies didn't have a general B. They had just had their framing, their framing license. And they didn't want to, they said that they weren't going to accept that as valid experience towards that general B.
Oh, did they just have a finished carpentry license or something?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Uh-huh. And then you're going for the general B.
Correct.
And so they're trying to say, okay, but what did you write as the descriptions for the work experience?
Well, the thing is that I didn't know that they just had their framing license. Uh-huh. I thought they had the general B because we did home remodels, but under that with that company.
Right.
So we did electrical, we did drywall, we did the ins and out basically, and that's why I put in that word description. But they said that since they didn't have a general B, they weren't gonna take it.
Right, but what did you write in the description? Did you write like things that's pertaining to what you guys were doing?
Yes.
Uh-huh. You did. Okay.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And so they're still saying no, they don't have the actual license classification. See, that's the thing. Just because, see, and that's the biggest thing here is that a lot of people have a classification. And they work outside of that classification all the time.
Uh-huh.
Right? Did you get an agent or anything that was over your case?
Yes.
And you got a number for that person too as well?
Yes.
Have you talked to her about or him about this?
Yes, I have, but she's saying that it looks okay to her, but once they pass it on to the, I believe it's to another officer, that he doesn't want to hear it. She says that it's totally understandable. Like you said, that's some companies do have a certain license, but they do all types of work outside that license.
Right.
But she's saying it's okay. But when she sends it for it to get approved, that the other guys doesn't want to approve it because the company didn't have that general B.
Yeah, I will ask her if you can write a letter stating what you have learned and basically. I wouldn't be defiant in it, but I would state that it's not your fault that company is choosing to do work outside of their classification. Uh-huh. Like the experience that you have cannot be taken away because a company is working outside of their classification. You get me when I say that?
Yeah.
You know, like my experience is still here. Like someone has signed off on my experience as you requested. But there was never something to where I'm supposed to be denied based on the company have a certain classification and them working outside of that classification. I will ask her if you can write a letter that she can present to that person.
Okay.
You know, and then in that letter, I would explain like your whole, you know, how your experience started, how you started working with that company. What type of work and detail you guys started doing and the knowledge that you gained from that and why you should be and why you're overqualified to have this license.
Okay.
You know? You know, it really sucks that they're basing your experience or the approval of your experience on the classification and not the actual work experience. That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Uh-huh.
I would definitely, ask her if she would be okay and what she think about you writing a letter, laying out those details.
Okay.
You know?
Uh-huh.
And
shoot her email as well, because I have her email.
Yep.
Because I know sometimes I give her a call and it takes her a certain time, but with her email, it's still a little bit quicker.
Yep.
I'll go ahead and shoot her an email just basically asking for that. And I had another question for you. I was looking at a couple of videos that you had about the RMOs.
Uh-huh.
And Now, I just had a quick question about that. If say that for some reason she doesn't allow me to write that letter, and if I do decide to go through an RMO, would I have to wait 4 years for so I can apply for my own license, or could I just wait for the 2 years?
Oh, you just have to wait for the 2 years. They're only denying you for the 2 years, but remember, the total years have to be within a 10-year period.
Okay.
So long as the next 2 years doesn't knock out the previous 2 years because it's older than 10 years, you're good. Long as it's all within the 10-year period, you're good.
Okay, yeah, that sounds perfect then. And where do you have your school is it? Because as soon as I get this figured out, I want to go ahead and get it enrolled just so I can take, because I know the basic knowledge is just that I don't have good test taking skills.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you provide classes for that or...
Yeah, I do. I have a entire school where people go through my class. We do live video online classes every Tuesday. So you can sign up for that whenever you get ready. Definitely keep me posted. Let me know what she says. But don't easily give up on it, you know. I don't know if you watched some of my videos. They gave me trouble too, you know, for my license.
Yeah. It's been going on for like three, 4 months that we've been going back and forth with the work experience.
Right.
And at this point, I'm not too sure what to do. That's what she basically said, that it's the first 2 years that they're not counting it because of that.
You know, it's so disappointing because we be so eager than we're ready for, you know? And to hear that is just like a blow. So, don't try not to take no for an answer. You know, if she doesn't agree with that, then you ask her, what is my best approach to this? You know, you've been at this for a while. How should I approach this? You know, if you're saying that a letter is not good enough, you know, what are my options? You know, what can I do? Because I really, really want this. And I can't make this experience go away. Like,
exactly.
I have it, you know? So what can I do if I can't write a letter, you know? What is my next steps? What is my next course of action? Please let me know and help me out.
Okay.
You know?
Uh-huh.
Tell her, man, and don't just get off the phone with just some, you know, bull crack and knuckle answer, you know? Get an answer, man, that makes sense and that's justifiable, you know? The answer that they're giving you now is not justifiable. It's not acceptable.
Uh-huh.
And it's not fair.
Yep.
You know? So, you know, we don't have to be assholes about it, but we do have to be firm, and we do have to, you know, show that, hey, man, I'm serious about this. I put in a lot of time to get to this place here, and I'm excited for my next, you know, level in life and for my family. And I just can't just let this go on one person decision. You know, what can I do to get this overturned? You know, what do I need to do? Do I need to call you every day, every hour? Do I need to send you an email every 3 days? You know, tell her, man. You gotta.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing lately. Because the thing that is, I have 6 years of experience, but my 4 most recent ones, they're also not accepting. What was it? 2 years of that. So I use the 2 years prior to that for it, and they're saying the same thing. So, but they're only getting my last 2 recent years, and the other 4, they're not even taking into account.
Now, the other 4 is with the same one company or 2 separate companies?
It's 2 separate companies. The first one, they're basically saying that it's because they don't have it, and then the other one has it, but I don't have proof that I worked with them besides the owner signing off on that, because I got paid cash, and that's what I was explaining. So I got paid cash. The owner can write you guys a letter that I got paid that amount.
Right,
but they said that it's not verifiable, so they're I'm not able to use it.
So you know, sometimes I have done for some of my students where we presented bank records to show that those deposits were put in, you know, during that period of time based on that pay rate, you know? Sometimes that work, you can ask her if that works, you know. Ask her, you know, what proof outside of a W-2 do I, because you're not the first one to get approved that's been working underneath the table. I have students that get approved from working underneath the table. It's just a lot harder sometimes you gotta talk to your agent several times, like, hey, can I see you over bank records? Can you just review those based on my hourly wage and my pay periods? You know, you can see these deposits that I put in there. And of course they're not accurate all the time, but you know, I have cash checks and I got some income coming in this account. Can you really look at it and just verify for me? And just take a look at it. And, you know, we have to go back and forth. And we usually get approved, but we got to just keep going back and forth. There was one time, man, I had to literally get on the line and almost cuss the lady out for one of my students, you know, because it's just like, I think a lot of those people really don't understand how hard we work for this moment. You know, they don't really understand, and they're sitting behind the desk with a pen, you know, crossing out a box, and I'm not a box, I'm a person.
Exactly.
You know, I'm not a sheet of paper, I'm a person. Like, and it just fired me up, man. And we wound up getting the guy the license, but they wound up putting him on a 2-year probationary period. You know,
yeah,
we was fine with that. Okay, fine. Yeah, yeah. Just give it to me, you know.
Yeah.
But I think they did that because I got angry and got involved and things like that. But yeah, go for it, man, and keep me posted. You know.
Okay.
Go for it, man. Make sure you call, send her email and lay it out, man, and you know, just let her know, like, hey, I'm open to any options. If this don't work, please let me know.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Sounds good.
Hey, make sure you subscribe, man. Don't be trying not to subscribe, man. I'm gonna hunt you down, okay?
Right.
All right.
All right. All right. Thank you, Tyrone.
You're welcome.
All right. Have a good one.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. So that was someone that follows the channel that called for some advice and really just asking, like, hey, man, you know, I'm at this place here. I really deserve my contractor's license. And you have someone that's out there that's basically saying, no, you're not going to get it based on the classification of another company. Not based on the experience I got, and I'm doing everything that you asked me to do. I have someone signed off on it. I listed a description of my work verification, everything that you asked for. You're not denying how my application is filled out, but you're denying based on the classification of the company. That sucks. And I wish it was my student. Cause I will go in on this one. Anyway, my construction entrepreneurs, just wanted you to hear that. I did on the fly. Hope you enjoyed it. See you on the next one. And if you got questions, concerns, issues, it doesn't matter if it's about questions about getting your license, your application, estimating, blueprint reading, anything with dealing with construction and building your business. If you're thinking about being a construction entrepreneur, give me a call. It doesn't matter if you attend my school or not. Okay. It doesn't matter if you're an employee of mine or not. I don't care. I will try to help you out the best way I can. And I'm going to leave you at that. And don't forget to subscribe and like and share. See you on the next one, my construction entrepreneurs. And remember, hustle hard, then hustle harder.